Welcome to Digital Communication Playlist. In this session, I'll explain code trellis and state diagram of convolution code. And this is what I'll explain by one example, so it will be more clear how to draw code trellis and state diagram for any convolution code. So let us begin this session. I have already explained this convolution encoder in my previous session. So let us have recap very quick. So if you see this shift register, this first bit that explains you input bit, and this next bit that is explaining state of convolution code. Here x1 that is what our output, and x2 that is what our output. If you see x1, so it is modulo 2 sum of m1, m2 and m1 and m2. So x1 that is what modulo 2 sum of m1 and m2, and if you see our output x2, so that is what modulo 2 sum of m and m2, and output is getting switching between these two. Now in this session I'll be explaining how we can have a code trellis and state diagram. So as m1 and m2 that justify state, we have predefined states. If m1 and m2 that is 0 0, it will be there in state A. If m1 and m2 that is 0 1, this encoder will be there in state B. And if m1 m2 is 1 0, encoder will be there in state C. And if it is 1 1, then encoder will be there in state D. So before we go for drawing of code trellis and state diagram, we should be calculating all the possible combinations which is there with this convolution encoder. So to have all possibilities, I have made this table, and we are dealing with to solve this first, and after that we can easily make code trellis out of it. So see, as I have told, m1 and m2 that will be justifying current state of convolution encoder. So for all possibilities, if I say m1 and m2 is 0 0, current state will be A. If it is 0 1, current state will be B. If it is 1 0, current state will be C. And if it is 1 1, current state will be D. Now why I have made this in this way, the reason is I just want to check if convolution encoder that is there in state A, and if current message bit that is 0, in that case next state that will be M and M1. The reason is when you insert next bit, this bit will get shifted in this direction, right? So next state that will be 0 0, what is that? It is A. So next state will be A. If you insert bit 1 with current state 0 0, then next state that will be 1 0, and 1 0 means it will be there in state C. If current state is 0 1, means it is there in state B, and if you insert 0, then next state will be 0 0, it means it will be there in state A. If you insert bit 1 here, then next state will be 1 0, it means it will be there in state C. If current state is 1 0 and current input is 0, then next state will be 0 1, it will be state B. If current state is 1 0, next bit is 1, then next state will be 1 1, it means it will be there in state D. If current state is 1 1, next bit is 0, then next state will be 0 1, it means it will be there in state B. If current state is 1 1, means it is there in state D. If current input is 1, then next state will be 1 1, that will be state D. Now see, I have already told our output x1 and x2. So x1 that is modulo 2 sum of m, m1 and m2, and x2 that is modulo 2 sum of m and m2 for this particular example. So based on this we can calculate x1 and x2. So x1 that will be 0 for this, and x2 is even 0. For this case 110, x1 is addition of all three, so it is 1, and x2 that is 1 plus 0, that is even 1. For this third case it is 001. What it means, addition of all three, that is 1 x1, and 0 plus 1, that is even 1 x2. Here x1 will be 1 plus 0 plus 1, it means it is 0, and x2, that is 1 plus 1, it means it is even 0. For this case 0 1 0, x1 is addition of all, so it is 1, and x2 is 0 plus 0, that is 0. For this case addition of 1 plus 1 plus 0, it is 0, and for x2 it is 1 plus 0, it means it is 1. For this case 0 1 1, x1, that is addition of all, so that is 0 plus 1 plus 1, it is 0, and x2, that is 0 plus 1, that is 1. And for third case there are 3 ones, so x1 is 1, and x2, that is 1 plus 1, that is 0. So this is how we can make this table. Now let us try to draw code trellis based on that. So now I will draw code trellis. Now how to draw code trellis? So I'll draw it step by step. So here you will be having input state. So there are four possibilities. And here there will be output states. So there are even four possibilities. Output state means next state. Now here when we draw this code trellis, there are two things that we need to keep in our mind. This solid line that explains input bit is 0, and this dashed line, it means input bit is 1. The solid line that explains input bit is 0, and this dashed line that shows input bit is 1. Now if current state is A and if you give input which is 0, then what will be the next state? So if current state is A, if input is 0, the next state will be A. So if input is 0, you will have to represent that by solid line. So it will go from A to A. And here output will be 0, 0. That one can see we have calculated x1 and x2. So output is 0, 0. So on the line, we will have to represent that with output. Solid means input is 0 and dash means input is 1. So if current state is A, input is 1, the next state will be C. So if current state, that is A, next input is 1, then next state, that will be C. So it will go from A to C, and on the line we will have to represent output. So if you see output, that is 1 1. So here we'll make it with 1 1. Now if current state is B, input is 0, then if current state is B, input is 0, then next state will be A. So from B to A there will be solid line as input is 0 and output will be 1 1. So let us make it on the line with 1 1. If current state is B, input is 1, then next state will be, if current state is B, input is 1, then next state will be C and output is 0, 0. So if current state, that is B, next input is 1, then next state, that will be C. So if input is 1, so by dash line it will go, output will be 0, 0. So this is how it will happen. Now if current state is C, input is 0. So if current state is C, current state is C, 1, 0, if input is 0, next state will be B, and x1, x2, that will be 1, 0. So if current state is C, input is 0, then next state will be B, as input is 0, you will have to represent that by solid line. So this is what solid line, and output as I have told you, it is 1-0, so let us make it 1-0 on the line. If current state is C, input is 1, then if current state is C, input is 1, then next state will be D and output will be 0-1. So next state will be D, let us make it with dashed line, and by arrow output is 0-1. So let us mention it on the line. And for last combination, if current state is D, input is 0, then if current state is D, input is 0, then next state will be B and output will be 0-1. So if current state is D, input is 0, then it will go to B and output will be 0-1. So I am making it over here. Output will be 0-1. If current state is D, input is 1, then next state will be D only. Sorry, it should be there with dashed line. It should be there with dashed line. This should be there with dashed line. And output, that is 1-0. So just write it 1-0 over here. So this is how we can have a code trellis. This is how we can have a code trellis. Now how to have state diagram? So state diagram, that is having different representation. So I'll make it in the same way as I have made it for code trellis. So if I say I have state A here, state B here, state C here, and state D here. Now here even we'll have to say this solid line means input is equals to 0 bit. And this dashed line means input is 1 bit. Means bit is equals to 1. So let us have a code state diagram. So we'll be making state diagram now by all possibilities. So where we will be representing all outputs. So let us start it with state A. Now see, for state A, if input is 0, then next state will be A and line should be solid. So if input is 0, line will be solid and next state will be A only. So I am just initiating from A and enclosing into A. Output is 0-0, so mention it with 0-0. If current state is A, input is 1, then next state will be C. Make it with dashed line. So see, from A to C, it is going by dashed line and output is 1-1. Output is 1-1. So over here, make it with 1-1. Now let us check it for state B. If current state is B, input is 0, then next state will be A. So if current state is B, input is 0, means solid line, next state will be A. You can see output is 1-1. So on state line, you'll have to show 1-1. If current state is B, input is 1, means dashed line, output will be C. So by dashed line, if current state is B, input is 1, next state will be C, and output, that is 0-0. So make it 0-0 on this line. Now let us have calculation for state C. So if current state is C, input is 0, means solid line, next state will be B. So solid line. So if current state is C, input is 0, means solid line, next state will be B and output, that is 1-0. So right over here it is 1-0. If current state is C, input is 1, then next state, that is D. You can see next state, that is D. So from here dashed line will go. The reason is input is 1 and output, that is 101. So write 01 over here. Now if current state is D, input is 0, then next state will be B. So if input is 0 solid line, next state will be B, output is 01. So just mention it with 01 here. If current state is D, input is 1, then next state will be D, output is 10. So by dash line, start it from D and close it to D, output is 10. So this is what state diagram. This is what state diagram. That is how we can make state diagram. I hope that you have understood this session. This is quite helpful in digital communication as well as in digital electronics. This state diagram and code trellis, that is so essential. So this is what you need to practice. And this is the basic process which I have explained how to have a code trellis and state diagram. I hope that you have understood this. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can give your valuable suggestions. Definitely I'll take care of your suggestions, and in future I'll try to make videos to sort out all the queries which you are placing here. Thank you so much for watching this video.